parasol buzzer. You start a thread at the eye of the hook, and I'm going to run it down and stop until it gets in line with the point, and bring it up just above halfway to there. Now the thing that makes this fly that extra bit special than any other one is basically the way that the CDC is tied in. What I'm going to do, I've got four CDC feathers and I've just pinched them at the top. It's about 2 centimetres or so, a CDC feather at the top, and I've just pulled the rest of the fibres away. And I'm just going to do this with the rest of them. Maybe about 2 centimetres, pull it away. Now I've got four here, so pulling them all away. Now, four of them, I'm just going to line them up so they're all following the same curve, they're all going the same way. Now that'll be what you're left with there. You want to tie these in with the curve. So basically you can see the feathers curving up here, that's the way you want to tie them in. You want to tie them in right here. So like a couple of turns, and then you can pull the stalks until you get a nice position that you'd like. The wing's going to be out of view for most of the filming. Now just bring these down at the back. Don't go down too far, and don't go around here with the thread binding them all down. You just need to bind a wee bit down and then trim it off. And make sure this is nicely secured in. Now bring your thread back up to the front, and what you're going to do is you're going to come on to the actual stem of the CDC feather. And this can be quite tricky, so take your time. Doesn't need to be perfect at first. See, what I need to do is just go up there, basically just kind of securing them in, you know, making them a bit more rigid using the thread like this, and basically just using crisscross turns. So you're going up in wide open turns, coming back down and crossing over. Now this is very hard to do. I'm going to try to come down and as close to touching turns as I can. Now, when I get back down to here, just run your thread down around the bend. Back up and do that bit again. Touch and turn the gun round, the thread's going to form the body. Now, go as far round as you want. I like to go just round to there. Now, what I'm going to get now is some pearl a very fine pearl tinsel, but in this case I'm using some pearl crystal flash, which you can just use to wind round. Tie it on down the bottom, come back up, close stitch and turns. There we are. Now you'll see when I wind the pearl round that it turns out to be a flat tinsel. The only thing is it is quite weak, so I'm going to varnish the body. There we are. Cross your thread. At this point, keeping the thread nice and tight, I like to just trim away or shorten the pearl. It's a wee bit too long, just shorten it. Trim that away. Bind that down. Now, I've got a goose bite here. I'm going to use the yellow goose bites. Yeah, and these are the Cook's Hill ones. Yeah, I find that the Cook's Hill is one of the highest quality materials that I've found. The Cook's Hill CDC is what I've used as well. Now, I've got two yellow goose bites here. I'm just going to put them onto the side with the tips. Three turns to hold that one. And another one on the other side. Now just secure them down. Like that. And get some black seals fur. This is the genuine seals fur from Vineyards. And if there's one thing I hate working with, it is seals fur. Now I like to wax my thread with seals fur, so just a bit of wax, and then just dub your seals fur on. Plenty. If there's any fibres that are a wee bit too long, you just pull them away. Now, just come in, pull one of your goose bites forward. I like to do these at one at a time. Come in at the front. Across and then just pull these back, keeping your thread nice and tight to this. Make sure they're nice and bound down. Now just go on your scissors. Nice and close, trim it away. There we are. And now I'm just going to get some varnish. I'm going to put a wee bit of varnish onto the thread. I'm going to whip finish. Four's plenty. Now don't trim your thread at this point, because what I'm going to do is just try to tidy up this bit a little bit. I'm coming right down to where you tie off. Tie off again. Oops, daisy. There's a tricky fly. There we are. And that's your parasol buzzer. Now all I'm going to do now is I'm just going to take the hook down a wee bit so I can show you this, but the CDC feather, I'm going to trim it only about a centimetre long, and that will just help to throw the water. So now that's basically how it's going to be sitting in the water there, at that depth. So basically about an inch under the surface, and you can tie these, you don't need to tie that buzzer like that, you can tie any buzzer on there. Maybe, you know, practically any buzzer that you've got. Be it this little guy here, you could tie him on. Just put that wee extended bit along there. You know, you could tie just anything really. Any wee buzzer that you've got, tie it like that. And it'll be sure to catch your fish. So that is your wee parasol buzzer.